Hello, my name is Dr. Prashant Fadnavis. I am a medical doctor by qualification and a passionate runner. I have been participating in various running events since 2016, ranging from 10Ks to full marathons. In June 2018, I started experiencing chest pain, which was initially diagnosed as Thiep syndrome, which is inflammation of the rib cartilage. I was advised to take time off from running, and I did rest, but the pain kept coming back whenever I would try to resume running. Finally, in Feb 2019, I had pain down the arm as well, the left arm. And then I was asked to undergo a treadmill test, which came positive for inducible ischemia. So then I was advised to undergo an angiography. I came to Fortis and Dr. Venkatesh, who was the head of cardiology at that time, he performed the angiography, and I was diagnosed with triple vessel disease. My right coronary artery was 100% blocked. My left anterior descending artery was 99% blocked, and my left circumflex artery was 65% blocked. And I was advised to undergo open heart bypass surgery under Dr. Vivek Jawali. On the table, they discovered two more blockages, so I ended up having a quintuple bypass.
Prashant is a young man. As you see, he's athletic. And at this age, doing a bypass surgery, coming with all the three arteries choked and their branches also choked, used to be unusual in India. Now, there are more people like him that we see today nowadays. What are the reasons? Reasons that there is definitely we are genetically different than the Caucasians and the Blacks and the Arabs. Our incidence of coronary artery disease like him is getting higher. Also, this heavy urbanization, the stress of this kind of exodus from countryside to urban areas, changing lifestyle, whatever lifestyle we have perfected over centuries in India, the original Indian lifestyle, we destroyed it in the last 17 years. And all these, the air pollution, the food is not the right food now today, and the water that we drink, those, everything has now ended up into all these non-communicable diseases. But whatever it is, genetic is something in Kannada what we call Hanebara, or in Marathi they say Karma Chepong. But he has no control on the genes that have come. So his problem is more genetic than anything wrong, because he's the most disciplined chakachak person. So he ended up getting 5 bypasses. There are 2 lessons in Fadnavis' cases. That A, whatever happens, even at this, he is still to peak in his life. So he's working very hard, his life is demanding a lot from him. But when something like this happens, you can still go through it, be calm, be disciplined, and you can see the end of the trouble and you can be like him. And many of us in medicine may not be like him. So the last TCS 10K marathon world race in Bangalore, it saw a huge participation, thousands, maybe 23,000-24,000 people who ran. In the first 500 was Prashant.
Yes, sir.
So his timing was incredible. 47 minutes he ran the whole marathon. So that kind of fitness is possible with 5 bypasses. So the lesson is that don't worry. And now these bypasses that are done, they should not fail. But in ways like our Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, he should not come for a second bypass. The kind of guy he is, he will not come. He has had 5 bypasses, out of which there are arterial grafts. They will stay on forever if he's disciplined. So you take care of your food, you take care of your walk and exercise, some morning sunlight, don't smoke, which is the most important number one. And take your medicines correctly, do some amount of self-supervision. You have diabetes, you have hypertension. Manage yourself, check yourself every week. Then you don't end up running behind doctors all your life. And just 6 monthly, once you come, make sure nothing is going wrong with the surgery and life is on. And you can be very hectic like him. And he runs marathons all over. He met my cousin brother during the marathon and they both became friends. And my cousin was telling me he was a fit guy. who is a marathoner, that he found him fascinating. His timing was less than him. So that amused me. So the lesson in him, there are plenty of lessons in him. That is why we are discussing and sharing this on social platform.
In addition, I would like to say I also ran a full marathon, a distance of 42.2 kilometers in March this year. It was 3 years after my surgery, and I clocked 3 hours 57 minutes 43 seconds, which is below 4 hours. It is something which healthy, normal, full marathoners aspire for, and I was able to do it despite having 5 grafts, thanks to Dr. Jawali, his care. So, yeah, like, you know, I would just like to say that bypass is not the end of your physical activity. You can be very active even after bypass if you work towards it. You have to, like I had to, first I used to walk slowly, then I graduated to brisk walking, then jogging, and then I started running. It took me about 6 months, but I was patient. I used a heart rate monitor to monitor my heart rate at all times, a chest strap. And 1 year, 11 days after the surgery itself, I ran my first half marathon, which was 21.1 kilometers in 1 hour 54 minutes 12 seconds.
Wow.
I broke my records. I've broken all the records which I had before surgery, after surgery.
Today, we have actually got a lot of froth out. If somebody is having those anginas, those doubts on the heart, and who have been diagnosed, basic diagnosis is always an angiogram. Angiogram still is not given away. And on angiogram, we decide whom to treat only with medicines, with stents, with bypasses. Those who have multiple blocks like him or the left main block, they all will need bypass. The rest will need something else. But incidentally, when he's mentioning about your marathon, I have to tell you one interesting thing. We have a laparoscopic surgeon in this hospital, Banagatta Road, Fortis, called Dr. Muralidhar. He's a pretty well-known laparoscopic surgeon. He used to be a little obese, and then he decided, like you, that he has to sculpt and he has to get into athletics. And so he started running marathons, and he completely melted down. He sculpted. He looks like you. And then he did something unthinkable to all of us. He ran Ironman.
Okay.
And he won the Ironman in Goa.
Wow.
And he went and represented us in Spain. You could tell our audience what is Ironman.
Ironman is a triathlon event. A full Ironman means you have to first swim 4 kilometers, then you have to bike 180 kilometers.
180.
And after that, you have to run a full marathon, 42.2 kilometers. And for this, you have a cutoff of 16 hours or so, 16 or 17
hours.
So all
in one stretch.
Yeah, one after the other. So it is swim, bike, run. It's a triathlon.
So there are guys like this. So bravo, all the best. Thank you for sharing this experience with our audience.
Thank you.
Bypass has come a long way. That is not the end of life. Thank you.